Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So in today's session we will move for the next order system, that is the number one, circulatory system. Okay, so let's discuss about the circulatory system. So human circulatory system consists of
blood vessels and heart. Okay, so these are the organs of circulatory system or circulatory organ. Which are the circulatory organ? Blood vessels and heart. Okay, so all these organs we are going to see deeply one by one. So let's discuss first, that is about blood. What is mean by blood? So the blood is a red color fluid. Okay, the blood is a red color fluid, and an average adult person has 5 to 6 liters blood. Okay, so the blood is a red color fluid and an average adult person has 5 to 6 liters of blood in his body. Okay, and that blood consists of two components. Okay, the bloods are having the two components, that are fluid components and solid components. Okay, so in the blood there are the certain components, there are the certain substances present. Certain substances are fluid, we can say that liquid, and the next one is what? Solid components. Okay, so the liquid components means what? Blood plasma. Okay, the blood is having the liquid state because of these blood plasma. Okay, next one is that solid components. The blood contains certain types of the solid components, like blood cells. Like which are the blood cells? Blood cells like RBCs, WBCs and platelets. Okay, so RBCs means what? Red blood cells. WBCs means what? White blood cells. And the third one is what? Platelets. So these are the three cells present in the blood. Okay, and that is nothing but what? Solid components. And which is the liquid components present in the blood? That is blood plasma. Okay, so this is about the blood. And why it is important to flow the blood in our body? It is very important because the blood can transport the digested food from the small intestine to the different parts of the body. Also it helps to transport the different excretory products from the different organs to the excretory organs. Also it helps to transport the oxygen from the lungs, and also helps to collect all the carbon dioxide and transport again back to the lungs. Okay, so in this way, to transport the different things, the blood can play an vital role. Okay, so this is about blood. Among the different components of the blood, today we will see the first components of the blood, that is what? Fluid component, that is nothing but what? Blood plasma. Okay, so the blood plasma is a liquid part. Okay, or it is the fluid part. See, plasma is nothing but what? Fluid part. Okay, because of the plasma, the blood is having fluid state, or we can say that what? Liquid state. Okay, it is yellowish in color, contain about 90% of water. Okay, so that plasma is a yellowish in color and it contain 90% of water and 3.5% of common salt. Okay, so the blood is a fluid part, it is yellowish in color, it contains 90% of water and 3.5% of the common salt. Okay, also it helps to transport the different things or the different materials in our body, like that we can say that digested food is there. Also helps to transport the different excretory products, and also helps to transport the different hormones which are secreted in our body. Hormones are the chemical substances which are secreted by our body. Okay, so all these things are getting transported in our body with the help of this plasma. Okay, next one we will see that the blood also contains some solid components. Okay, and which are the solid components? Blood cells. Okay, and there are the three types of the blood cells are present, that are RBCs, WBCs and platelets. Okay, so let's see one by one deeply. First one we will see that what? RBCs. Okay, RBCs means what? R stands for red blood cells, RBCs. R stands for red, B stands for blood, C stands for cells, RBCs. And also it is called as what? Erythrocytes. Okay, the red blood cells are also called as what? Erythrocytes. Okay, so see, the blood is red in the color, or we can say that the blood is red in the color because it contains what? RBCs. Okay, but why the RBCs are having the red color? Because RBC red in color due to red pigment, and the name of that pigment is what? Hemoglobin. Okay, so the RBCs are red in color because they contain the one type of the pigment, and the name of that pigment is what? Hemoglobin. Okay, and this hemoglobin of the RBCs, or the hemoglobin of the red blood cell, helps to mix the oxygen into the blood. Okay, so that hemoglobin helps to mix the oxygen which are coming out from the lungs into the blood, and then it get transported to the different parts of the body. Okay, so it is a very important thing which is present in the blood. Why? Because hemoglobin helps to mix the oxygen in the blood which comes from the lungs, and then it get, with the help of the blood, it get transported to the different parts of the body. Okay, so this is what RBCs, that is what? Red blood cell. Okay, and the average lifespan of the RBCs, or the average lifespan of the red blood cell, is what? 120 days. Okay, it can live up till from 120 days. That is the average lifespan of the RBCs. And these RBCs are the small in the size, and they are like a disc shaped. Okay, they are like a disc shape and they are small in a size. Okay, so this is about what? RBCs, or also we can say that what? Erythrocytes. Okay, so today we have discussed about the human circulatory system, which are the circulatory organs, which are the parts of the circulatory system: blood, blood vessels, and heart. Also we have discussed about the blood, and also we have discussed about the liquid components of the blood, that is nothing but what? Plasma. And also we have seen the one solid components of the blood, that is nothing but what? RBCs or erythrocytes. Okay, so the next point we will discuss in the next video. This is the time to tell you goodbye, and for today, thank you.